Hey guys, welcome to episode number 4 for the big 1-2. I tried to do that then, but I've just got the big one. The big 1-2-3-4. Big 1-1-1-2-3-4. Video number 4 of the. What a shit introduction. We're here with episode 4 of the Invincibles. You know the drill by now. We're playing not to lose. So far, we've won 4 games out of 4. Win today wins us the league title. We're obviously... I mean, where have you been if you don't know? We're obviously the Arsenal boys. The young guns have been impressing in real life. This is a bit in the past, but just recently Martinelli did an absolute madness in the Europa League. Scored, I think, 2 and set up 1 against Liège. So he's going to get the start for us today and over Pepe, who's been a bit disappointing. Lacazette's going to come back into the fold because I think we missed him last time out. Smith Rowe didn't really impress. Ceballos didn't do much when he came on though. So we are going to give... Who are we going to give a go? I don't know any of these people, so... Tell you what, we'll give Callum Chambers a go in midfield and move Guendouzi into a more advanced role. We're going to bring Bellerin back into the side. And you know what? Let's get Rob Holden in there. Socrates... We'll get rid of Socrates. So that's the lineup we're going with today. I just want to check. See, I want to have the wing backs on overlap because I don't think they're getting forward nearly enough. I don't think we've really got any of this set. We'll leave the rest because it's going well. But I want those fullbacks to get forward more. I hope you've all been well. Obviously, still waiting for career mode to start. One little thing I have been thinking, where career mode isn't out yet, I've been playing quite a lot of Ultimate Team. Got gold in the first foot champ, so that's always a big win. I've got quite a bit of coin, so I was wondering if anyone, and you know, be honest if you think this is a shit idea, type shit. I was thinking of maybe doing some experiment videos on Ultimate Team where we try and do stuff that no one else really does. So my first one that I was thinking is to get Ronald Koeman, who's a centre-back, and see if we can kind of produce a similar goal-scoring record to what he had in real life, but still using him at centre-back. So I think he was like a 1-in-2, 1-in-3 guy. And everyone on FIFA, I mean, if you played FIFA, pretty much plays with the back four, including the fullbacks staying back and the defensive mids. I play a lot more attacking, so I'm thinking, what if we move that even further and go centre-back Koeman, get him pushed up and see if we can score goals with him. Just some, you know, some weird videos like that I don't think anyone else is really doing. They can also be quite, you know, player reviewy that he's also good at defending and whatnot. If you've got any interest in player reviews, any experiment videos like that, let me know. But we are up against Chelsea. Aubameyang's been played in. Sold the defender down the river. Callum Chambers on the edge. Oh, do you know what? Maybe Callum Chambers isn't a good idea because he can't shoot from there. Will it? That was a terrible finish, wasn't it? Jesus. All three centre mids have come over to this side. Martinelli, he's seen the run of Guendouzi. It's a lovely little ball. Willock, what is Willock's finishing today? He's gone, you can tell, right, I'm upset already. You can tell this guy's A, not a Chelsea fan. Don't have a problem with it because, you know, I'm not an Arsenal fan, so use who you want. But also not a football fan because he's chosen Batshuayi over Abraham, which to me shows, you know, he's just a bit of a loser, the guy I'm playing. He's a bit, he takes the game a bit too seriously. Take that, that's what you get. Because for me, when I use Arsenal, I want to use the players I see in real life. Why would I not choose Tammy Abraham? This is what he gets. The other option is that I am playing Michel Batshuayi, which is, you know, plausible because he's certainly not getting any games for Chelsea anytime soon. Zinger. 20 minutes in, I think it's been a good start for us. He's going to score, isn't he? Oh, it's just wide, thank God. I think we've started positively. That's one thing they have to fix. I don't know, you know, you probably didn't notice it because I pressed X so quick. But if you just aim it out wide and press pass, the defender, the goalkeeper even, takes an age to just pass it. And usually they've gone and covered the option by then. So I think they need to change it up because it can be quite hard to play a goal kick short on this game. Lacazette! This is why we brought him back into the fold, ladies and gentlemen. The Pied Piper, Lacazette. Look at that. A delicious finish. Chips are really good this year. They're really fun. As a bonus, here's one chip. I've scored about 50 that I scored on Ultimate Team to show you what I mean. I really like the chips like this. where they're very close range. So that one I scored with Lacazette, you know, it was because the keeper is off his lines. But the one you do, the little dinks, they're quite Messi-esque, where you just get close to the keeper, dink it, and the keeper goes down for it. And, you know, they feel real good when they come off. Who do you guys think has been the star of the show? Obviously, we're only four episodes in, but who have you looked at and thought, you know what, that guy's the nuts? Because I think we would have all thought beforehand it was going to be Pepe. But he's been a bit lightweight so far, taking time to adjust to the head-to-head season's life. I think Lacazette, Aubameyang, Guendouzi, obviously, you know, I'm always raving about. Chambers, times it perfectly. Lacazette. Obviously, you know, I'm sure a lot of my viewers are FIFA fans, but I know some of you just come here because you like Jack Stevens as a personality. There have been no updates on when the career mode fixes come in. Obviously, you know, we're almost a bit in limbo until we find out, because I'm definitely not starting it beforehand. Quite a few YouTubers had, and I just think, you know... Is that not a free kick? Unbelievable. Quite a few YouTubers have started their career modes, and, you know, I don't want to start beef, but I think they're fucking idiots. Because, I mean, like, it's on the record that quite often after two or three seasons, the Champions League breaks and stuff like that. We look fighting well. That was weird. Yeah, it's on record that after two or three years, the Champions League will probably break, and the game, you know, will just... You'll kind of want to stop once that happens, because what's the point? Yet these YouTubers have gone, oh, I need to start it as soon as possible, so I'm going to do it now. And it's like, alright. But when you get to December, episode 30, and you're like, the game's now broken, it's a fucking joke, this company, it's ridiculous. I think, you know, it is ridiculous, but you knew when you started it, this is probably going to crash. So you can't put all your time and effort in, and then when it crashes, go, this is a joke, it's crashed. It's like, yeah, you fucking knew it would crash, you ditzy moron. Half time, we're tuning up here at the Emirates. Last little flag. Oh, he's quit. I'll tell you what, we'll do a special. We'll do a 2-in-1 episode, because you guys have been so well behaved so far. 5 wins out of 5 so far. Game 2 on its way, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to put Guendouzi back in the hole. And I'll tell you what, we're going to go Mez McMurzmill. Big Mez. How's he looking this year? He's got flair. Let's find out how much flair he's got, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's the wrong fucking button. If only I could make a deal with God and get him to swap our places. Been running up that road, running up that hill, running up that building. Right, Borussia Dortmund are a very good team on this game. They've got a lot of quality all the way through, like they have in real life. So this could be one of our trickier games so far. Oh, here's Ozil with his flair. How's he going to do? Brilliant. Oh, no. I thought he was definitely passing. Good save, Leno. This could be the end of the Invincibles. I've got a very bad feeling. Maybe if this is a hard game. Jesus Christ. I mean, how fucking high is that ball gone? And I haven't won it. If this is a hard game, at least I could put it to Kate Bush running up that hill and make like a cool montage. That might be fun. I just need to focus. Plays it long. Get rid. We'll play it. Mats Hummels is a lunatic on this game. Bicycle kicks? Falling over? Then again, which modern footballer doesn't fall over? I tell you what, this guy's got me on the ropes early doors. Dived in. No! This isn't good. This really isn't good, because if we lose, I've got nothing left, because I refuse to start a career mode just yet. That's a great ball. Aubameyang stayed onside. Lacazette in that gap, man. Why was he so slow? Obviously, I said I would give you some clues with the player career. So, in an ideal world, we'd be starting at the club he started at in real life. But the club he started at in real life aren't actually on the game. So that's just another clue. If you had some ideas, you can maybe go and eliminate. It's a bit like Guess Who, you know? You can go and eliminate some of them with that clue. So the club that he started at in real life are not on the game and are in the Brazilian league. Martinelli. Lacazette. Martinelli. Go across goal. Oh, straight in the keeper. David Luiz again. He's having a bloody good game. That's good football. Joe Willock can't afford to miss another big chance. Joe Willock, I've tried to chip it. Ah! It's going straight at him. Oh, David Luiz. Oh, David Luiz is having an absolute blinder. It's nerve-wracking. 30 thumbnails, as you know. This is definitely the closest we've come to defeat. Pepe is on the bench. Do we bring him on now, or... I think we've got to bring him on now. Get him on early so he can make the most difference there. Tell you what we're going to do. We are going to bring on Saka for Willock. Willock's been good for us, but he's squandered quite a few big chances this episode, including one this game. And in a series where you can't lose, you can't afford against a good opponent to miss big chances. So we're going to give Saka a go instead. Dumb thing to do. But he's done it. Saka. The super sub. What foot is he? I don't know what foot he is. Saka! Oh, how has he saved that? It's coming. Aubameyang, surely. What a save by Roman Berkey. Bollocks. Pepe! I thought that was the moment. 60 minutes gone, we're past the hour mark. We need a late Ian Wright goal. You know, one of those invincible. I've gone fast. No, Royce! No! Shit! Let's go attacking. 49 games I made it last year. We are on the sixth. I've dived in. He's got the ball back. I'm trying to mark it. No! This is where the laughter stops. I don't know what videos I'm going to upload if we lose this, boys. And I'll let you in on a secret. We're definitely losing this. No fucking backbone, this Arsenal side. No backbone at all. They don't usually have happy endings. Everything we've done so far, I think you could argue, during my YouTube career, has been a pretty big failure, you know? We have... failed definitely at Barcelona. You could argue we failed in the player career by getting sent off and relegated in our final league game and then not winning the World Cup. And in a series where we're going to try and go 50 games unbeaten, we look set to lose the sixth game, which, you know, as far as failures go, in terms of the strict numbers, there's certainly a case to be made that this is the worst, yes. He's on. He's just onside. He is just onside. Lacazette. Right, he sent the keeper down. Let's go. 3-1. 3-1. Skip the replay. Come on, boys. The belief is there in the stadium. Ozil sends it. Fuck off, Mesut Ozil, you fucking tosser. That is why he hasn't played this whole time. Possibly sends Pepe through. Got the ball. Oh, why? Why are they so bad at passing? That needed to go to Ozil on the edge. It's genuinely over. Lacazette. Straight through the middle. Aubameyang. He's got to get there. He's been fouled. I mean, it's definitely game over. We've cocked up the whole Invincibles. But can we score a free kick, ladies and gentlemen? Can we go out in style like Taylor Swift? Aubameyang. Against his old team. Well, what now? I mentioned those ultimate team experiments at the start. I hope you want to see them because that might be what comes next. Oh, mate, it's a fucking nightmare. It's a nightmare. I lost the sixth game. I managed 49 last year. Look. I'm not one of those people who says every game I deserve to win that game, because I think he did make better chances than me. But my God, we squandered some good ones, right. Well, thanks so much for watching. Don't worry about turning up next week. Hit the subscribe button. Something new will be coming soon. So the two ideas I've had lately, as I say, are kind of maybe a weekly, fortnightly video on Ultimate Team based. It might be something like, as I say, trying to get Ronald Koeman to score, have a good goal scoring record from centre-back, something weird like that. It might be using certain players that you want to see me use and kind of using them for 50 games and doing a review. Not going to be one of those people who plays with a player for 3 games and says, this is the best player I've used. You need to play 50. So maybe stuff like that if you want to see that. My other idea was a career mode. I know what you're thinking, Jack, you've just said how terrible they are. I have. But I'm thinking one maybe a bit like that YouTuber Barfy Boy, where each video is around half a season, and the main goal of the series will just be to build a really good youth academy in somewhere like Austria, you know, a country like that. Use just youth academy players and just try and sell them for loads of money. So just try and produce good players, sling them on their way. A bit like Salzburg in real life. You know, so just an academy of good players that we're churning out and selling, or Ultimate Team stuff, or maybe they'll fix player career and that will come soon. I hope you enjoyed the Invincibles. I've got 26 thumbnails for sale if anyone wants to buy them. This has been a disaster. I've been Jack, thanks for watching. See you later.